Well, hello there, you lucky viewer. It is now time to enter into
the Fingerboard Experience,
where we build fingerboard parks, or we build part of a fingerboard park in this video. In this video, we're going to be building the cave section, and this is going to be a magical cave that can do lots of cool things. So, I'm going to spend exactly 5 seconds telling you about the advertisement, so go to undialedbusiness.co. And now that we're done with that, the first thing I'm going to do with the skate park is I'm kind of just going to arrange all of the dry objects where they need to go before I start putting down like concrete and stuff. So without further ado, watch me arrange these products. I have not removed that piece, so literally like, you can see this. It is all being held up by the previous section, which is really cool. But there's gonna be some more support for this thing in this video, so I don't wanna leave this section hanging. One of the first items that I have is I have this salt lamp. I'm pretty sure this is just a cube of salt. Yep. It is a cube of salt. I'm gonna be using this as kind of a light up rock feature that's inside of the cave. So this is a really cool object that I'm excited to use inside of the fingerboard park. And that is going to be placed right inside here. This is crazy. The hole is drilled out there so I can have a place for the cord of the salt lamp to go. There's gonna be a few more cords running through it as well, so it's just gonna be a port to outlets. So I got 5 different types of tiles right here. We got flat stones, we got 3-dimensional stones, we have more bricks, we have hexagons, and we have flowers, or I don't even know what this is supposed to be, but they are geometric shapes. What I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna arrange all of these tiles into a nice little floor plan that goes inside of this section. So yeah, let's do it. Oh, I also have this one too. I'll put this one in. All right, guys, so we've just finished the flooring. Clayton did a beautiful job making this look very smooth. And now it is time to build this restraining wall that is gonna be part of a quarter pipe. So let's get started on that. We'll be right back.
Alright, so this park is looking very dirty right now. It's time to clean it up. Ooh, look how clean it is now. So you see that rail right there? Yeah, that one.
I gotta remove this rail. And if you guys have been watching this video series since the very beginning, you'll know that this is the original Fingerboard Park. So I'm gonna take out this rail because this is not the ground that I want. This type of wood right here is not what I want to be fingerboarding on. I mean, it's pretty smooth, it wouldn't be bad, but it's just, it wouldn't match the theme. So I'm going to take the same type of wood that I have right here, this masonite, and I'm going to make a masonite section over here, but in order to do that, I have to take out this rail first. So let's take it out. Alrighty folks, let's see how this piece of wood right here fits in. Ooh, it fits perfectly. So you're probably sitting at your computer, or I don't know, sitting on your phone somewhere, and you're probably thinking to yourself, Will, why is there a rectangle here? Will, why is there a rectangle here? And to answer your question, I am going to make once again, another little scene that's gonna just be cool and all aesthetic, because that's why I like building this park. It's just fun to build little things like this. So I'm gonna build a little panel of the floor you can actually see down into. So in order to do that, I'm gonna need to grab my handy dandy pencil, and I'm gonna draw out a little rectangle within it. And then I'm gonna cut out that rectangle with the jigsaw. Dang, that's a good hole. Time to paint it. Alright, so no one will actually ever see this, but I think it's just funny for the viewers, so you can laugh out loud. Ha 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 ha. Alright guys, so I have these LED copper string lights. And what these are going to be used for is basically to light up the roof or the ceiling of this cave looking thing. And I have to do this before I add any more concrete, so it's just easier to get to like accessible points and whatnot. So I gotta do this before I add any more concrete. So let's install these. It's gonna be kind of interesting. I don't really know how I'm gonna do it, but if the video goes longer than this point right here, then you guys know that I've succeeded. All right, so I'm gonna attempt to hot glue these lights into place. I don't really know how this is gonna go, but hopefully it goes pretty well. All right, this method is not working. I was trying to hot glue those lights and it did not work at all. So what I'm gonna do now is I have something new. I have this clay, this Italian clay, and we're gonna be using this, and hopefully this works pretty well.
So let's install these lights.
So I made a little bit of a mistake. I cut the lights and they all just shut off. Fortunately, I know that I can make them all turn on again by simply just touching these two right here. And now see they're on? So basically I have to just connect these lights so that way they'll turn on all the time. So let me do. Got some sandpaper, I need that. Alright folks, well, this piece of masonite is installed and it looks very dandy. Now it is time to put some concrete down. So I've created this little piece of coping right here that's going to be the lip of a little kicker that I'm gonna build. So that's the next thing we're gonna build out of concrete. right now we are going to build a little side piece that's going to attach right here in order to hit this rail better. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to screw some of these 2x4 scraps to the side of the table, and then I'm going to build concrete off of those. So let's do it.